Unity is a very tight-knit community. We have a lot of different organizations. We have a lot of volunteers that support those organizations.
The Resource Center was initially born from an interagency committee, a committee of community groups who really wanted to fill the gaps in our community.
Groups as diverse as the Food Bank now operates out of the Resource Center.
There was also supportive employment, the parent mentorship program. Our public health nurse goes in one afternoon a week to talk to moms with new babies.
We've also initiated a secondhand clothing store, New to You, and so that people in the community can donate the clothing that they no longer need, and we sell it at very reasonable prices.
Wilkie Independent Living Service is a nonprofit organization that's funded by the Ministry of Social Services. We support individuals with intellectual disabilities.
We are a nonprofit organization. We exist on grants and donations. We also do have some income from our secondhand clothing store.
Our philosophy is not to over-service people with intellectual disabilities, but to provide them and to teach them the skills necessary to live as independently as possible.
The board is made up of volunteers, and the volunteers come from the different areas of the community.
Everything we get into up to our elbows and up to our necks. So whether it's green paint on Main Street or whether it's a resource center or the home, I feel that there's a real sense of community here.
Unity is a better place because of these volunteers that have gotten together and had noticed a need and a gap in our community.
When they develop programs or events or new projects, they ensure that they're including everybody within the community.
Everybody is in full support of all of the projects, and you can't have successful projects if you don't have that community collaboration.
There was a flash flood in the city July 1st, 2010.
I was driving and trying to get home, and it was raining so hard my windshield wipers could not keep up with it.
I had to go to my friend's house, go back home, have a cry, and then go back and help her.
We actually were on the site of where the skate park's gonna be now, and the water was about neck deep.
The plan was brought to us by Dave Neusbaumer with Feral Agencies, and he is also an Aviva broker.
I approached the mayor and I said, listen, there's this contest. What if we entered to win a skateboard park? But I said, we'd need some land donated. And he said, well, we have the land already designated.
There were 1,800 applicants initially.
He said, what's the prize? And I said, $150,000 for first prize is the category we're going in. He said, if you enter it and you win, I will get council to approve, we'll match it dollar for dollar.
So seven businesses donated $1,000 each, and they did an amazing radio campaign.
I started with a video that I made myself initially that I just put on YouTube.
Joan McCusker, former Olympic gold medalist on a video, Jarrett Stoll from the Los Angeles Kings, Dave Rodney, who's a Saskatchewan, a Yorkton resident, summited Mount Everest twice. We built a video with them and then threw in all the tragedy of the flooding and then the creativity of the Aviva Community Fund Park.
My colleagues and myself, we have a lot of contacts within the community, so we could rally people, connect them to each other to say, listen, this is something really exciting that's happening and you can make a difference.
I think they're projected by the end of August, beginning of September to be done. We'll have the ribbon cutting then.
It didn't feel like work at any point. It was just such an exciting project to be involved in, and now we're going to see the concrete end results with this amazing plaza.
Our current skate park is just bustling every day. Like, so many kids out there, whether they're on their bikes or scooters or skateboards, whatever it is, at least, you know, they're out there, they're active, and they're excited about the new park that's coming.